walk through the garden, you gotta watch your back. Well, I beg your pardon, walk the straight and narrow track. If you walk with Jesus, he's gonna save your soul. You gotta keep the devil way down in the hole. He's got the fire and the fury at his command.
That's right, new song. Went on a little long. I don't mean to be rhyming. This much rhyming is wrong. But that's, of course, Mr. Tom Waits, and in my estimation, certainly the greatest, perhaps the greatest American musician, songwriter, singer in the history of this country. Although I'm not that aware of the music that was being made here before recorded music. So, yeah, let me just couch it like that. Anyway, that's down in the hole. Matthew 12:33, either make the tree good and its fruit good, or else make the tree bad and its fruit bad. For a tree is known by its fruit. Brood of vipers, how can you, being evil, speak good things? For out of the abundance of the heart, the mouth speaks. A good man out of the good treasure of his heart brings forth good things, and an evil man out of the evil treasure of his heart brings forth evil things. But I say to you that for every idle word a man may speak, they will give action. They will give account of it on the day of judgment. For by your words you will be justified, and by your words you will be condemned. Now, words are a powerful thing. I'm a super huge fan of words. Love words. Love them. Love them. Love them. One of the many tattoos I still want to get when I can afford to get more is the old wrist style. That's right, a wrist tattoo. I know it's becoming the tramp stamp of the new millennium, but and little I heart words, because I love words. I think they are beautiful. I really only speak English, paltry amount of Spanish, and even ridiculously less of French. But I just love words. I love that we were able to crystallize our expression and try to find that perfect word to express ourselves more than our body language can, more than our, you know, because when you can't, like, really explain a thing and you just start being like, you know, it's like, but, you know, so it's with a trace of, finding words for that. Is gorgeous, and I also think words are super important, of course, because I gravitate towards this, loving them already, which I wanted to give fair warning of, but words are important. I mean, the law of God, where God is like, okay, you want to know what I'm all about, and what pleases me, and what doesn't? Well, in some ways, it was already writ large on your conscience, but here, let me give you the lesson, and it was actual words inscribed on rock. Words. The permanence of the written word. Like, established the law with his people. Pretty amazing. It was like a brand new style of covenant that wasn't just, I am God and I will prosper you. It was like kind of the whole next, it was next phase. And John, as you may know, used the word as a name for Jesus, as a name for Christ, and spoke of Christ as dwelling with God before all things, and was as much an eternal parcel of God as he was sort of the quote-unquote Son of God. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. And they say the universe was spoke into being with words. Let there be light. And then everything exploded. And that's when they started making cool stuff. Or starting things on their cool path, however you want to look at it. I don't really care. But words are huge. Words are important. And beautiful. And they are made beautiful by, again, by what Christ is speaking of here, by the content of our heart. Our content of our heart and our imagination and our creativity. And again, as I truly believe, everything we do is intended to be, in our truest intent on this world, is intended to be an act of praise to God. Not to praise or exploration of our central self or our truest self or the divine within us, but indeed the divine without us, outside of us, and a hymn of praise to God's ears. And indeed all of our words should be the same, even if they aren't literally, "Hey God, you're amazing, praise you, Lord, for your glory and your wisdom, for your beauty and your understanding, for your law and your mercy." But indeed that everything we say, just as everything we do, that which you do to the least of mine, you do also to me. That which you say to the least of mine, you say also to me. Way over time already. But let us try that together, all who are devoting with me right now. Let's try it just this week, man. Let every word be prayerful. Try for just one whole day and say a lot. Don't hide out. Go say a lot, and let every word be edifying and be pleasing to God's ears. It's hard. I don't know if I've made a whole day without saying some stuff that I was like, what? Why would you even say that, sicko? And it helps that I have a life partner to point things out to, but yeah, let's try it this week, shall we? This will be Words of Praise Week. Let us extol that which is beautiful, that which is good. Let us speak as God speaks. Edification and truth. Amen. Selah.